Hi, and welcome to this ForNAV Coffee Break. My name is René Brümmel. I'm a product specialist at ForNAV, and I will be your presenter today. As this coffee break is live, you can ask your questions via the GoToWebinar question window. We will answer them at the end of the coffee break. Today, we're going to keep header, body, and footer sections on the same page. In rare cases, it is absolutely necessary to keep certain blocks of information on the report on the same page, no matter what. ForNAV has its KeepWithNext property, which tries to keep sections of the same type on the same page, but that won't work for sections of different type, like header, body, and footer. In this case, we need to gather the information we want to display in a JavaScript array, so we can print them in a single section. That sounds more complicated than it is. Let's go and have a look. To demonstrate keeping sections on the same page, I'm going to use these steps. The prerequisites, what do I need to get going? In step two, I will gather my data in an array. In step three, I will create my new section and table. In step four, I will display data from my array. Let's start with the first step. Today, I will work in a Business Central on-premise server with the Business Central 2023 Wave 2 release. I've installed the ForNAV customizable report pack and I've executed the step-by-step wizard from the assisted setup to get started. Of course, everything I do today will work for a cloud environment as well. I've also installed the ForNAV designer, which can be downloaded from the ForNAV website. The first thing we will do is store our data in an array. That sounds complicated, but it is well within the capabilities of someone who is new to JavaScript. All we need to do is store some data while ForNAV iterates through its dataset. So let's go into Business Central. Let's go into my ForNAV reports. And before we get started, I will show you what my invoice currently looks like, because I'll be playing around with the VAT lines on my sales invoice. And if we look down, you will see that the VAT lines are split across two different pages. I mean, all of the data is there, so it's not a really big deal, but it doesn't look very nice. And this is just a simple block of information that usually you would like to keep together. So let's go and do that. Open the report in my ForNAV designer. There we go. Now, what we need to do when we gather data is gather the data whenever ForNAV opens the data item from the database. So this VAT amount line is going to be read from the database, and every time that this line is going to be read from the database, I want to store my information in my JavaScript array. So to do that, the first thing I'm going to need to do is to create the array. I can do that in several places, but let's just stick it in the on-pre data item of my VAT line. There we go. And I create a new variable VAT lines. And I assign this variable with an empty array. I don't specifically need to assign the empty array to my variable when I create a variable. JavaScript can do that on the fly, but it makes everything in ForNAV a bit easier, because now the ForNAV IntelliSense knows that the VAT lines is an array. Then when I have created my array, then every time the VAT amount line is read from the database, I want to store some information. So in the onAfterGetRecord, I open my JavaScript array editor, and I will type really quickly. What I'm going to do is create a new variable VAT line. I'm going to do that on the fly. And this is an object. You can see it's an object because it uses the curly brackets. And in that object, I am going to add the VAT amount line, VAT identifier, VAT percentage line amount, VAT amount, and VAT base in my object. And these names are names that you can define yourself. I usually use the field name, but with camel casing, so a lowercase first letter, which makes reading everything a bit easier. And as soon as the line has been created, I'm going to push the VAT line in my VAT lines array, which means I'm going to store the data in my array. And that's all I need to do to gather my data. The next step is to create a space where we can display our data. To do this, we will use a dummy table as an anchor with a simple body section. The section must be set to can grow so it can grow with the size of our data. We will use a table inside the section so we can use that to create header and total lines. So, sounds complicated, it isn't. What we need to do, since we cannot display all of our VAT amount line data until all of the lines have been read from the database, we cannot use any of the standard VAT header or bodies to store our data. We could use the VAT footer if we wanted to. The only trouble is that footers cannot grow inside ForNAV, and we want something that grows automatically with the size of our data. So I'm just going to add a new data item. This is going to be an integer data item, and the integer table in Business Central is a dummy table, which simply counts from minus forever to plus forever. And to make sure it doesn't count until forever, I am just going to set the max iteration to 1. And that basically gives me a single record where I can display some data. I'm going to call it dummy. You can call it anything you want. In here, I'm going to insert a new body section. I will call this combined VAT body. And again, the naming your sections is not mandatory. I usually do this because if you want to inherit this from a master report, then it's nice to use to inherit combined VAT body instead of having to figure out which of the body 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is the one you want. I'm simply going to copy and paste the header table from the VAT header because that already contains all of the header information that I need. And in here, I'm going to insert a row below. And I'm going to insert another row below. And then I need to clean everything up a bit because everything right now is bold, which I don't want. And I need to set my alignment properly. So I will do that right now. Then what we need to do is the data set that we have might be one line, might be two lines, and might be 10 VAT lines. So the middle table is going to need to grow automatically, and the section itself needs to be able to grow automatically as well to match my data size. So on the section, I'm going to set can grow to yes. And on the middle table row, which is table row 2, I'm going to set can grow to yes as well. And finally, we only want to display this VAT body when we actually have VAT information. So to do that, I'm going to set the show output of this section, and I'm going to say VAT lines dot length is greater than 0. So only when I actually have data in my VAT lines array, I'm going to display this section. And that's it. That's all I need to do. Next step is to get the data from our array. And to do this, we will use JavaScript's native array tools, which are very powerful. They're also very well worth studying if you want to create advanced reports. There isn't an advanced report that I made in the last couple of years that didn't have some form of error because they are so powerful and so flexible. So let's go into Business Central. Sorry, let's go into ForNAV and see what data we want to display. I'm going to open the JavaScript editor of my VAT identifier first. And let me type something really quickly. What I have here is a single line that selects the right value out of my array and joins it into a list. So I've got my array, and if I go back to forth, the array has a function called join, and the join function of an array joins all of the records in or all of the entries in the array with a joining character. And the joining character in this case is a backslash n, which in JavaScript means a new line. So that's going to join all of the values in my array in a list. And then, of course, I only want the VAT identifier part of my array. And to do that, I'm going to use the map function. And a map says from the VAT line, get the VAT line dot VAT identifier. We will do the same thing for the VAT percentage. Then we get to the actual decimal fields. And in here, we are going to need to do something slightly more, because the join joins everything as a string, which means that the standard decimal formatting in ForNAV doesn't work. So we need to do some manual decimal formatting. So instead of VAT line gets VAT line dot line amount, I'm going to say VAT line gets core report dot net format of the VAT line dot line amount with this format. We've discussed the .NET format in an earlier coffee break, so if you want to know exactly how that works, then please look it up. In this case, this is going to get me a list of all of my decimal values formatted in the 0.00 format. I'm going to do the same thing, of course, for the VAT amount. And of course, I've prepped all of this before, so I've got the entire script on my other screen, which makes my life a bit easier and makes this webinar slightly less boring. So now we have all of the values which are joined. Now all we need to do is the sums. Unfortunately, JavaScript has a really cool function that can calculate the sum of an array for me as well. To do that, I've got the VAT lines map again, so the mapping works the same. So I want to calculate the sums of the VAT line line amount. But to calculate the sum, I'm going to use the reduce function of the array. Again, it's just bog standard JavaScript. And the reduce function takes the total and the value, and it adds the value to the total. To read, it's pretty simple, but I do admit that these arrow functions here may require some studying. If you want to know more about the reduce function or the map function, I can heartily recommend W3 Schools, which you can find on Google, which helps me out every time I have a question about JavaScript arrays. So I'm going to do the same thing for the VAT amount. And I'm going to do the same thing for the VAT lines map. There we go. So that's it. Unfortunately, we've only got 5 columns. And really, that's it. That's all we need to do. Let's preview our report right now. And of course, in our report, we have the old VAT stuff, which is broken off. And we've got the new VAT, the new VAT section, which looks pretty much the same as the old one. The only thing we need to do right now is to hide the old VAT sections. And you can hide them. In this case, I'm just going to delete them because I don't need them anymore. Preview the report. And you can see that the VAT lines don't start underneath my subtotal because they are now compressed into a single section. ForNAV just puts them, places them on the next page because it doesn't have space on the first page to print the entire section. So that's nice, cool, and useful. So let's recap what we just did. We have loaded the VAT data in a JavaScript array. We have created a new integer data item as a placeholder for the VAT lines, and we have created a new body with kangaroo set to true to hold the VAT data. Since all of the VAT data will be displayed in a single body, it will always be on the same page. Finally, we loaded the array data in our table cells by using the array.map function. The array.map function selects the right value from our VAT line object. This works well, but only for data items with a few lines, like the VAT lines. If these combined sections get too large, you will get illogical page breaks, because if your combined section is about half a page or three quarters of a page high, then the page before that may have only a quarter or half the page filled. So it might look illogical. So it works perfectly, but I would recommend keeping it for smaller tables with not that much data. Let's go to the questions. I can see we have a question here. So let me see if I can make this question readable in there we go. Is the .NET formatting not necessary for the sum line? No, the .NET formatting is not necessary for the sum line. If we go into Business Central again, you will see that the sum line doesn't use the join, which means that JavaScript doesn't format this as a string, which means that JavaScript formats this as a decimal because it is an actual decimal. And if it is a decimal, ForNAV knows that the standard decimal formatting is 0.00. So I hope that answers the question. I cannot see any further questions at the moment. So let's go on and wrap up this coffee break. If you want to know more about ForNAV, or if you want to download the ForNAV Designer and Converter, please visit our website. If you want to install ForNAV in Business Central Cloud, please visit the Microsoft App Source, and you can watch more videos about ForNAV on our YouTube channel. If you have any questions about ForNAV, please email them to support@fornav.com. For a full list of upcoming and recorded coffee breaks, please visit fornav.com/coffee break. Thank you very much for joining me today, and goodbye.